Welcome back to the Suraj Podcast. We are continuing on with the stories of Guru Hargobind. In the previous episode, we talked about how Guru Hargobind tested this Nath Sadhu named Kalu. And this was as Guru Hargobind was leaving his battle camp situated around this very large pool, this pond. And as they were going back to the village of Kangar, where Jodh Rai was from. So that's where chapter 57 picks up. It was evening time when Guru Hargobind had punked this Nath Sadhu called Kalu. And the text mentions how Guru Hargobind spent the rest of the night there. He woke up in the early morning, and the text mentions how they set off now to Kangar with both the Sikh army and then Jodh Rai's troops as well. So approaching Kangar, along the way, Guru Hargobind stopping with Jodh Rai, they're having a good time. It mentions they're having quite a laugh as well. They're laughing with each other as they're hunting on the way back. When they reach not far from Kangar, Guru Hargobind sets his camp a little bit outside the village and tells Jodh Rai, you should go home now, meet your family, and then we'll meet later on. Jodh Rai accepts this. He goes back, meets his wife, tells his wife about the battle stories, what happened. If you remember to the episodes prior to the battle, Jodh Rai's wife was the one pumping Jodh Rai up about, acting, with courage, believing in Guru Hargobind's ability to defeat any army that approaches him, not to be fearful. And it was through, if we remember, Jodh Rai's wife that Jodh Rai became faithful in Guru Hargobind, because Jodh Rai's wife had come from a Sikh family. So she hears about this. She's really excited about meeting Guru Hargobind. So she quickly goes after hearing these stories. She salutes Guru Hargobind. And Guru Hargobind, then when he sees her approach with such love and admiration, Guru Hargobind then blesses her and saying that, being such an amazing woman, you'll receive, bliss in this life and in the next. To always keep the Guru teachings in your heart. And through this, you'll find whatever desire you wish in the world. Any obstacle in your path is going to be eliminated by doing this. So she replies saying that, Guru Hargobind, just please make me your servant. You're my protector. It is your nature that you always protect your servants. You are essentially, the invisible force guiding all action. You are the cause of all action. And being so, please then guide my mind for to forever remain on your lotus-like feet. So she says this in a very devotional manner, and she does another salutation, and then she goes back to her home to prepare a very large dinner for Guru Hargobind, which after eating, Guru Hargobind then praises the food a lot, saying, it's quite delicious, very, very nice. And after this meal, then it mentions when Guru Hargobind goes to sleep, he wakes up again in the last phase of the night. So the last phase of the night would mean that Guru Hargobind's waking up about 3 hours prior to sunrise. So in the Indian system of time, they are 8 watches to a day, 8 sections of a day. This is divided up as 4 being of the night and then 4 during the day. So the day phase, the first section of the day, starts at sunrise, and they all last 3 hours. So, if the sunrise is at 6 o'clock, this means that Guru Hargobind is getting up about 3 o'clock in the morning. So it mentions he gets up at this time. Guru Hargobind then uses this time to meditate. And it mentions that he's meditating upon the Atma, the self that is in everything. Self with a capital S. So not individualistic, but meaning it's, transcendence, in everything and everywhere. So then when day broke, when the sun came up, it mentions Guru Hargobind then gets dressed. He puts his weapons on. He starts to wear his formal attire, and a court session then begins. A divan was set up, and congregation from all around the area came to meet Guru Hargobind, talk about the battle. They were bringing various types of gifts for Guru Hargobind, food rations, etc. From the nearby village of Pairupa, Sadhu and Rupchand come, both father and son, and they're having a discussion with Guru Hargobind about the war. Guru Hargobind tells them about how Sohela, the really fine horse, died in battle. You know, there's some praise that Jodh Rai levies on the horse to say that, you know, this horse had such great fortune that, you know, it was able to give its life in battle in your service. There's more discussion. You know, Bidhi Chand chimes in, talks about, he tells the congregation, tells Sadhu, Rupa, and others who are nearby, how the other horse, Janpai, was again feeling anxious, was feeling really upset about losing his friend, how Guru Hargobind then, you know, calmed his mind. So it mentions how the congregation is having these discussions about the battle, about what took place, and this lasts for about 3 days. You know, there would be a divan, there would be this court session set up where, you know, kirtan would be played, and these discussions would happen with the people coming to meet Guru Hargobind. And then it was on the fourth day that Guru Hargobind then goes out with Jodh Rai, and they roam around that area, and they actually go quite, they cover quite some distance, and mentions many kilometers that they go down before setting up a camp. And along the way, they're just hunting, and you know, again, it mentions how Guru Hargobind's having this laugh with Jodh Rai, like they're really getting along, and they're having a lot of fun during this hunting expedition. So they set up camp. Like I mentioned, this is quite some distance away from Kangar at this point, quite in the thick of things in terms of the forest and the jungle. And at this moment, when Guru Hargobind had got off his horse, he's standing there with Jodh Rai. They're having, again, it mentions this laugh. Guru's laughing as he turns his head and sees from out of the bushes, this really big python is just pokes his head out. And then slowly just slithering, crawling its way towards Guru Hargobind. Immediately, Guru Hargobind yells to his warriors saying, "Do not approach the snake. Everybody stand back. Let it come to me." So everybody's wondering, you know, what the hell is going on here? They see this massive snake. They're wondering why Guru Hargobind's told them not to, you know, quickly make work of this snake. So the snake is very slowly slithering its way to Guru Hargobind. Everybody's looking at it and knows that, oh, this snake is not right. Something's wrong with this snake. It's in pain. It's like hissing in a very loud sound, you know, indicating that it's in you know, extreme pain. It's coming really slowly up to Guru Hargobind. At this point, Guru Hargobind takes his shoe off, and with his right big toe, he touches the snake very slightly on the snake's head. And at this point, the text mentions that all of the sins that the snake was carrying on it were destroyed. It mentions how this snake was, the whole body of this massive python, it was very thick, very long, was injured. It looked like something was wrong with this snake. And slowly then, as it died, people are watching it, that these small insects are like eating its way out of the snake. So slowly, there become more and more of these insects just eating their way from inside out of the snake. And Jodh Rai is standing there watching this. He's bewildered. He's like wondering, you know, what the hell was this about? So he respectfully asks Guru Hargobind, saying, you know, what's the deal with this snake? Why did it come up so slowly to you? You know, why did it die after you touched it? Is snake looked like it was suffering so much? Is there a reason why it was suffering? Like, what led it to suffer in this way? So Guru Hargobind then says that, you know, this snake, in its previous life, it was a Mahant. It was a custodian or a spiritual leader who was really well respected, really famous of this area. And people from all around this area would come and bow down to him, give him endless gifts. You know, these bugs that are eating the snake from inside out, well, these are the servants of that Mahant, of that custodian. You know, this custodian, this Mahant, had this crazy, extraordinary ego, and he thought that, you know, nobody was like him. He was the best. in this whole area. People were bowing down to him, but at the same time, he never took time to contemplate the divine, nor did he, you know, do anything else of use, you know, any other type of righteous action. So he collected all these followers, and he didn't even instruct them, give them proper teachings to, you know, meditate, connect with the divine, or do some type of good righteous action. And he lived his life in this way, and then he died with this ego, you know, having a hold over him. And in doing so, he stopped his followers from finding peace in this world and in the next. So basically, as repayment, these servants now are eating him from inside out, because he didn't help them when they required help, you know, in regard to any type of spiritual instruction or teachings. So this is the payback that he gets for having that ego and not helping people that relied on him, essentially. And so Guru Hargobind is saying that, you know, he didn't save himself, this Mahant, this custodian, and he didn't help anybody else. So, you know, this is basically what happens to people who have these large followings, you know, and they don't connect with the divine. In the same way, Guru Hargobind then is mentioning a Shabad, a passage written by Guru Nanak. This is in this is a slok on in a rag malar. So the passage is, Kulhan dende bavle lende vade nalaj, chuha khad na maavai tikal banne chaj, den dwaye se mare jinko den se jahe, Nanak hukam na ja pai kithe jaye samahe. Essentially, this passage is saying that these really respected people, they give their servants these hats, kulha, are these type of Sufi kind of hats, that sali topis that people wear, and it's an indicator that, you know, this person's my servant. So these idiots give their servants these identifiers, and then these like shameless people accept them, and not only identifiers but gifts, you know, like praise. And it's saying that the next line is then is a metaphor to say that, you know, a rat, if he's wearing something big, a mouse, can't then, you know, go into his little hole. Basically, in carrying this baggage of these gifts and this like honor and praise, you can't get to where you need to go. And it's saying that the people giving these gifts and these honors, these religious identifiers, you know, they die, and the people taking them, you know, thinking that they've achieved something, they die as well. And at the last line of this says that Guru Nanak says that, you know, nobody understands the order, the nature, the will of the divine about, and then, you know, where these people will go and where they will rest, basically, in the afterworld. So Guru Hargobind says this, and says that, you know, these type of people, they don't do anything for themselves, nor do they cultivate any type of wisdom either. And because they're so blind with their ego, they don't contemplate the divine or do anything of any meaning either. So just for the sake of their following, they undergo all these things, they go through all these pains to get such a following, but they don't do anything good. And because of this, then they're reincarnated again and again to experience this pain. But at the end of this, Guru Hargobind says that, but this snake still, you know, he had some good fortune, which is why he was brought to me here. And now, you know, because he has, you know, given his life here, I've liberated him from this painful existence that he had. And this is where chapter 57 then ends. And then the next chapter will speak more about Guru Hargobind as he spends time in the village Kangar, and his interaction basically with Jodh Rai and his wife. So that's where we'll pick up next time. But as always, I wanted to extend my gratitude to those who continue to support this podcast through the Mangalacharan Patreon page.
ਜਾਊਗਾ ਝੜ ਕੇ ਖਾਲਸੇ ਨਾਲ ਅੜੇਗਾ ਪਰਲੇ ਲਾਲਾ ਮਰੇਗਾ ਸ਼ਰਨ ਭਰੇਗਾ ਤੇ ਚੜੇਗਾ ਗੱਜ ਗੱਜ ਕਰ ਜਾਵੇ ਗੁਰੂ ਹਰਗੋਬਿੰਦ।